Hi, Drew.
Hello, how are you doing?
Nice to see you.
Looking good.
Nice to see you. Hi, nice to see you. You
marvellous. Right,
please,
in here,
come in.
I
please
suppose.
Come in. Of course.
Looking at it. Blimey. Look at that lot.
A lot of this has been here a long time. This is mostly Afghanistan area,
okay.
Hindu
right.
Kush. I've got lots of big architectural things. That's the sort of entrance to a haveli. That's a chokidar's door.
A what?
Chokidar, that's where the gatekeeper would come in and out. Chokidar. And it would be enough height for an elephant to come through.
No. Oh, is that why?
Yeah, yeah.
What a brilliant fact.
Yeah.
I don't think this is a sort of place which is open to the public at all. I think it's for you know, invited dealers, which is exactly the sort of place that I very much like to go to. And the places where I find my best stuff. Is that the roof of a bed?
No, this is a ceiling from a house, a painted ceiling.
That's fantastic.
But you really, you know, you need to see it painted.
What a thing.
It's beautiful.
I keep looking at everything going, I need a bigger house. None of this will fit in my... None of this, that's bigger than... Yeah. That's...
Well, you always have problems getting the elephants in and out, though, don't you?
I do, yeah.
George spends 6 months every year in India, and also has a network of contacts all across the subcontinent who are always on the lookout for pieces that will interest him.
These things, these pots up here, what are these about?
These are old honey buckets.
Interesting.
That's a Quran stand. Book stand.
Oh,
for the Quran.
It's so roughly made, aren't they?
But still beautiful. Carved out one piece of wood, look.
I'm just studded with my mouth open. We are in the English countryside, quintessentially English countryside, wandering around looking at 18th and 19th century bits of Indian relics and architectural odds and ends. Brilliant. Couldn't be having a better day. Great fun. The thing I like is this.
I get a lot of jali. In Asia, they call it jali.
Jali screens. These for windows, are
pierced.
They?
Anything pierced is called jali.
There is what he calls a jali screen. It's got a nice coloured paint on it. It's got that lovely blue that they seem to have done a lot of things in. You hang it on your wall, put all your little doodads in it, little bits of toy cars and whatever, photographs, whatever, you can do anything with that.
Jali screens were used in Indian architecture to allow air to flow in through windows while creating intricate shadows, both to decorate an interior and keep it cool. This one dates from the 1930s and could be worth around £150.
Well, how much is a jali screen going to cost me?
That?
Yeah.
20 quid.
20 quid? Thank you very
Cheers.
Much. I think that's fantastic. What a piece of wall art, whatever.
You could put a mirror behind it, look fabulous.
That's
mirror
a good idea.
It. Put a mirror behind it, looks amazing.
A little bit boho, that, isn't it? These chain things, there, what are they?
These are original. These are lamps, temple lamps.
Where do you put the lamps?
All right, let me explain. The oil will be here and tapers will be here.
Oh, right, yeah.
They put oil and they hang them in the temple.
Oh, nice. I'll tell you what, you could have a cracking game of Conkers with them, couldn't you?
Yeah, couldn't you just? Hey? Couldn't you just?
These seven handmade temple lamps are likely to date from the early 19th century and come from northern India. Made of brass with brass chains to hang them, they would have burned oil or incense to light and create scent in temples and homes. They could be worth around £125.
How much are they?
I'd do them for 25 quid a piece.
You're, really? Well, I have to buy those.
Sure.
Happy days. That's exactly what I was looking for. Something really different. Lots of them, unrestored, not a lot of money. How much? £25 a pop. Put them in the van. We'll have those. Thank you very much. Don't know what I'm going to do with them. I just really like them. Right, what have we got in here?
This is where you keep the loot.
The loot.
What's that all about?
They're just little dowry chests.
These are a bit of fun, aren't they? So, yeah, early 20th, you reckon?
Yeah. They're not ancient, but they're nice boxes, decorative. They're covered in brass. It's like repoussé work thin brass on wood.
They're little dome-top chests covered in hammered copper and brass and metal. And we're looking, God, there's loads of them. And then they've got elephants and animals and birds and all sorts of things all over them. Which area of the country did these come from?
These come from the Great Thar Desert.
Okay.
Rajasthan.
Rajasthan,
out towards the Pakistan border.
Okay. And they're marriage chests, dowry chests.
Yeah, people give them.
Okay. So they're a common item?
Not common. Not common.
It's what the people would bring into the marriage, so that the lady would bring this to the marriage with her money in or gold or whatever. Yeah, great. Really nice.
These hardwood Rajasthani dowry chests are around a century old and are decorated in what's called repoussé work, where thin sheets of soft metal are hammered from the reverse side to create a low-relief design. In need of minor restoration, these could be worth around £300 each.
How much are these?
They're going to be 50 quid each.
These are very good prices, you know. They really are. That one's sold. I've got a feeling I think I'd buy them all. Let's not mess about. We'll have that as well.
OK, fine. Yep.
The dowry chests today just smashed it for us, really. If one came up, and I'm looking at one, and somebody said, well, it's 150 quid and it's a bit beaten up, I'd bite their hand off. So for seven or eight of them at 50 quid each, of course I'm going to buy them. I quite like this one. How many have we got?
Seven. OK,
that's brilliant. Made the day. Thank
Good.
You very much.
Thank you very much indeed.